Can infected mother with COVID-19 breastfeed her baby? Breastfeeding is the cornerstone of infant and young child survival, nutrition and development, and maternal health. The World Health Organization recommends exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months of life, followed by continued breastfeeding with appropriate complementary foods for up to 2 years and beyond. Early and uninterrupted skin-to-skin contact, rooming in, and kangaroo mother care also significantly improve neonatal survival and reduce morbidity, and are recommended by WHO. However, concerns have been raised about whether mothers with COVID-19 can transmit the SARS-CoV-2 virus to their infant or young child through breastfeeding. Recommendations on mother-infant contact and breastfeeding must be based on a full consideration of not only of the potential risks of COVID-19 infection of the infant, but also the risks of morbidity and mortality associated with not breastfeeding, the inappropriate use of infant formula milks, as well as the protective effects of skin-to-skin contact. This scientific brief examines the evidence to date on the risks of transmission of COVID-19 from an infected mother to her baby through breastfeeding, as well as evidence on the risks to child health from not breastfeeding. Current evidence suggests that breast milk is not likely to spread the virus to babies. WHO recommends that mothers with suspected or confirmed COVID-19 should be encouraged to initiate or continue to breastfeed. Mothers should be counseled that the benefits of breastfeeding substantially outweigh the potential risks for transmission. Mother and infant should be enabled to remain together while rooming in throughout the day and night, and to practice skin-to-skin contact, including kangaroo mother care, especially immediately after birth and during establishment of breastfeeding. Whether they or their infants have suspected or confirmed COVID-19. Helpful tips for starting or restarting breastfeeding. You may find it harder to start or continue breastfeeding if you are not sharing a room with your newborn in the hospital. Here are some helpful tips. Frequent hand expression or pumping will help you establish and build milk supply if you are separated from your newborn in the hospital. Pump or feed every 2 to 3 hours, at least 8 to 10 times in 24 hours, including at night, especially in the first few days. This helps the breasts to produce milk and prevents blocked milk ducts and breast infections. If you have COVID-19 and choose to breastfeed, wash your hands before breastfeeding. Wear a mask while breastfeeding. Sanitize your hand with alcohol rub. If you have COVID-19 and choose to express breast milk, use your own breast pump, one not shared with anyone else, if possible. Wear a mask during expression. Wash your hands with soap and water for at least 20 seconds before touching any pump or bottle parts and before expressing breast milk. Follow recommendations for proper pump cleaning after each use. Clean all parts of the pump that come into contact with breast milk. Consider having a healthy caregiver who does not have COVID-19, is not at increased risk for severe illness from COVID-19, and is living in the same home, and feed the expressed breast milk to the baby. If the caregiver is living in the same home or has been in close contact with you, they might have been exposed. Any caregiver feeding the baby should wear a mask when caring for the baby for the entire time you are in isolation. These steps can be helpful